Believe it or not, I'm not always a Memoji. This is the actual Jacob, so hi. I thought I'd try something a little bit new with this video, so let me know in the comments later if you like this style. Anyway, you're probably aware that today is Apple's developer conference, which means they've shared some exciting new updates about all of their operating systems for the year ahead. As well as being interesting for developers, it's also hugely interesting for us non-developers and Apple fans as well, as they've announced some important new ways that your devices will improve this year. That means new features and experiences coming to your iPhone, iPad, Mac, Apple Watch, and more. So in this short video, I'll run you through the most interesting updates to the iPhone for this next year, in the form of iOS 16. I'll be honest, I was going to try and pick my top 5 new features, but I just couldn't do it. So here are my 6 features to be looking out for when iOS 16 gets released to the public later in the year. And hey, be sure to give this video a like when I get to the feature that you're most hyped for. Starting off, we've got messages. Now, guys, you can now edit and delete messages. Yeah, seriously. No more accidentally sending love hearts to your boss and no more awkward typos. You can now simply long tap and then edit a message as much as you like. Your recipient will see the message was edited underneath next to where it says delivered, but not what the original message said. An undo send is a great way to effectively delete a message that you didn't mean to send. And you can also mark messages you've received as unread, which means you can go back to the conversation when you've got the time, rather than forgetting about it because you've read it already. I'm looking at myself here, to be honest. I'm the worst at opening a message, getting distracted, and then never replying. Well, no more. Now, let's have a look at notifications and live activities. So, notifications are going to be a little bit different in iOS 16. For a start, they'll appear from the bottom of your lock screen, and they'll be easy to hide when you don't want them. It seems to me they're becoming much more discreet and subtle, and less in your face than before. You can now swipe down and they'll be gone, clear from your lock screen. Another awesome feature is a special type of notification called a live activity. So these show up at the bottom of your lock screen, and they'll keep you up to date with fast-moving situations in real time, like a sports game, a delivery, or perhaps the status of your Uber pickup. Imagine this working with transport apps like City Mapper. Being able to get off the train right from your lock screen on the right stop, in real time. So good! Speaking of the lock screen, I have plenty more to say about that in a minute or two. It is so, so good. A really great feature that I'm excited for is iCloud Shared Photo Library. Seriously, this has been a really long time coming. With family sharing enabled, you can now have a whole new iCloud Photo Library that automatically syncs between family members. Don't worry though, you're in control of which pictures do and don't get shared. Phew. iOS will also use some machine learning intelligence here to suggest images that you might want to share, such as when you're out on a trip with family members nearby and a few of you are taking pictures, or maybe when a family member pops up in your selfie. That means you won't miss out on photos and you can all curate, edit and contribute to that shared photo library whenever you like. There's even going to be a toggle in the camera app to automatically send pictures to the shared library as you take them, if you'd like to. These images will then show up elsewhere on your device, such as in widgets, memories, and more. This is such a good feature, and I can't wait to finally be able to share over 5,000 cat photos with my fiancé. I bet she can't wait either. There is so much good stuff here already, and there's still more to come. I know it's quite a lot to take in, but don't worry, I'll be breaking each of these features down into bite-sized and easy-to-follow QuickTips tutorials in a few months' time. Make sure you press that subscribe button down below, I've got to say it, and turn on your notifications so you don't miss any of these QuickTip videos when they drop. Okay, back to my 6 iOS 16 features, and yes, I will get to those incredible lock screen updates as well. Let's have a talk about the Home app. Now this is a big one for me. The Home app has been rebuilt, and apparently with a focus on speed and reliability. Thank goodness. It's also got a nice new layout, where it's easier to identify tiles and accessories, and a clever filter bar at the top that will show you certain types of devices when you need them the most. There are also new widgets for the Home app that provide valuable data in real time, both on the home screen and the lock screen. Apple Pay. Well, there have been a couple of nice updates to Apple Pay. But the standout for me is the Buy Now and Pay Later in Installment service that Apple are calling Pay Later. This will be available anytime and anywhere you use Apple Pay, and will let you split a larger purchase into 4 payments over 6 weeks, There'll be no interest charges and no fees will be applied here. You'll be able to see upcoming payments right inside the wallet app. Oh, and you'll also be able to have live order tracking too, both in the wallet app and on the lock screen. Okay, it's time. Let's talk about that lock screen. So without a doubt, this is the biggest feature in iOS 16, and quite simply, I am astounded by it. Now, if you've used an Apple Watch before, you'll already be familiar with how this works. From the swiping sideways to move between screens, to the long press to edit them. You can add widgets, which do look a lot like Apple Watch complications, and customise their appearance and style. In fact, you can customise the appearance and style of everything. Font, colour, images, layout, animations, themes, styles, the lot. It's honestly pretty mind-blowing, and I can't wait to get my hands on and explore this when iOS 16 is released. Now you can link lock screens to focus modes and have them switch automatically when you arrive at work or at home or the gym. You can browse a vast library of preset styles to use as a starting point. And there are some lovely looking portrait photo effects here too. Oh, and did anyone see the live weather effects and 3D animations between the lock screen and the home screen? Wow! It does all get me thinking. With these customizable widgets that look a bit like Apple Watch complications, I wonder if these are sowing the seeds for an always-on display come iPhone 14 in September. You know, picking just six features to talk about has been really tricky, especially with so much good stuff announced this year. Updates to dictation, Memoji, live text in videos, maps, privacy, CarPlay, all of that is coming too, and I'm sure there'll be plenty of QuickTip videos later in the year about all of those. Have I missed a feature that you're really excited about? Well, let me know in the comments down below. I'd love to hear what's getting you excited about iOS 16. And lastly, whilst I know it's very tempting to install the public beta of iOS 16 on your iPhone, I should share a word of warning. Reports are that the first betas this year are potentially a bit more buggy than normal, so it might be worth holding off a few weeks longer until they're a bit more stable before putting it on your devices. And that's it for today. Don't forget to subscribe down below for all of those quick tips coming later in the year, and I'll see you again soon.